Buster and I, here we are sitting at North Perry Airport. There's Buster sitting there in the co-pilot seat. We are headed to Freeport today and starting our trek through the Bahamas. So we are starting old school at the old North Perry Airport. Somewhere wedged in between Fort Lauderdale International and Miami International. So, pretty simple flight today. We're going to be taking off west here. I'm going to make use of 28 left since it's so close. No one's at the airfield right now. So, we're up on VATSIM, but we don't, there's no controllers out there. So, we're gonna proceed out straight west. We're gonna climb, and then we'll make our northeast turn into Fort Lauderdale. We'll pass right over the Fort Lauderdale VOR, which is located on the airfield, and then from there we'll depart out to the northeast to Foles, then Pattis, and then into Freeport. So anyway, that's the plan. And then from there, Marsh Harbor, maybe Nassau, a number of the other islands. We're just going to take a whole tour of the Bahamas. Love the Piper Seminole by Coronado. That's what we're in today, and that's what we'll be in for the whole series. So, anyhow, what do you think about that? Buster likes it. All right. So, let's go ahead and get started with our setup. Seat adjust and locked, belt harness fastened. You set there, Buster? Okay, good. Just want to make sure brakes are set. Let's just make sure we got this. Yep, brakes are set. Circuit breakers in. Check. Landing gear down. Check. Avionics off. Check. Cal flap open. I have a preset alt 1 for me because I can't see the cowl flaps for nothing from here. I mean, see, if you're here and you look down and you try to do the cowl flaps, I mean, you certainly can't see the right one. But anyway, that's my preset. Carb heat off. So that's right here. Carb heat is off. Battery switch. Get rolling. So we landing gear 3 green. Yep, alternator's on. And fin strobe is in the right spot. Let's get on our nav lights and our recognition lights. Let's go ahead and check them out, Buster. So we got nav lights. Back up. Fin light. Beacon. Good. We're set. We've already fueled up. So just so everyone sees it, here we are. We've got 647 pounds in there. So that's about 108 gallons each. I don't know why it's showing. Yeah, it's about 100. I don't know why it's like this. But anyway, everything's thrown off right here. Let me. It's kind of weird. There we go. Yep. Okay. So we basically got about 108 gallons total. Now I'm not, well, it depends on how I weigh in, but we're saying Buster 70 pounds, and we got 70 pounds of bags in the back. I mean, after all, we are going to the Bahamas, right? All right. So that's just so everyone sees it. That's what we got going on today. And there's our fuel. So we're all good. Okay. Let's go ahead and get our left engine on. Okay, magneto switches. Let's get them on. Mixture, rich, prop, high. Let's get our left throttle open a half. Prime. How many primes should we do, Buster? Two? All right. All right. Let's go ahead and fuel pump. Clear prop. Looks pretty, pretty clear. Here we go. Well, what did I do here? What did I not do right? I bet you I did not do. Ding, ding, ding. Field selectors. Duh. Maybe I should use the checklist. All right. Here we go. Try one more time. I hear you, Buster. Fair prop. Amazing what a fuel selector does. We are in the green as far as bolt pressure goes. Ammeter, boom. Suction pump. Well, if anyone knows where the suction gauge is, please tell me. It should be there. Right here? No, that's where the probably should be here. Anyway, I don't see it. So if anyone wants to comment, let me know what I'm missing. That would be awesome. Alright, go up off. Let's reduce this throttle. Let's get us down to 1,000. Okay, let's go to the right. Mixture lane prop up. Let's go a half an inch open. Okay, we're good. Let's prime. Buster said 2 primes, so let's get our magnetos on. So this just happened. So it's 300 at 310 statute miles. We're broken at 1,100 feet and broken at 200 feet. So we're in a marginal VFR. Okay, overcast 2,900. We're squawking at 300 niner. to that. I mean, it kind of gave. I mean, the altitude cannot be high here. It's got to be almost ground level. 8 feet all the way around. Okay. Yeah. Okay. We're still gonna take 2-8 left. Simple. If there were people here, I'd take 2-8 right. But there's not a soul. Let's get the right engine. Come on. Alright, here we go. Alright, let's go ahead and get rocking and rolling. Perry traffic, Seminole 806 Alpha Mike, taxiing to runway 28 left via Lima, North Perry. Everyone's like, North Perry? Where's that? Okay. Put this bad boy down. Usually, our lights will be... Let me get this off. How am I looking? Is that good? Okay. Yeah. Usually, our deal is showing up right here pretty easily. Let me go to the outside. Let's see if I got the right footprint. Hey, we're missing out. The right degree. How interesting is that? Oh, yeah, the right degree. But there's no registration. Interesting. How do you do that with pre-flight? Anyway, can't worry about that. Noticed the little placard right there didn't have our registration, so never seen that before. That's like two things we've never seen before. Okay, let's get going. We've already said we were going to taxi, so let's do what we're going to say we're going to do. Perry Airport, Seminole 6 Alpha Mike, taking runway 28 left for the westbound departure. North Perry. Okay. Here we go. Release the parking brake. Get your landing gear. Landing light on. Tailbuster and I have not had much time in the Piper Seminole. I guess about 6 hours. Interesting. You can see where I've shut down one engine for taxi. That's the difference, right? So maybe we'll have to equalize that out. Okay. Gotta rotate at 75. Landing gear will come up once we have no more runway left in positive rate. If we do lose an engine prior to 75, we're going to throttle back max brake. If we lose an engine right after rotation, again, we'll see if we can put it down. If we can't put it down and gear up, we will fly out at 90 on one engine and get back into the pattern left traffic. If all is smooth sailing, we're going to go out to, I would say, around 2,000 feet before we engage autopilot, and then we'll transition over Fort Lauderdale. We need to be over 4,000 feet at Fort Lauderdale, ideally 5,000, but I don't want to interfere with any of the traffic, which right now there is none. We might actually get a good view of the Hard Rock, so that should be a little bit of fun. All right, fuel pumps are on. Let's do pre-takeoff. Fuel selector's on. Trim is set. Yeah, let me set the trim. Should have done this earlier. We're gonna put everything back to 2525. Call it. Okay, let's go ahead and pull our throttles back to 25 on the inches. And then let's get our props on 25. Climbing out at 90. We're still solid. Seminole 6 Alpha Mike is at 2,000 feet clear, runway 28 left. North Perry. Alright, here we go. Let's go ahead and let's pop our heading. Let's reduce our climb. So we are in one heading. Let's go ahead and flip this around. Get Buster. Sorry. 3,500. Climbing at 105. Right on the money. That's a good offer. Throttle's a little bit more. Started to leak a little bit. Fuel pump's off. Okay, the after takeoff checklist is complete. 4,000 feet. Nice weather change. Okay, so if we wanted to bear to it, it'd be 06, so let's just bear to it. Actually, let's let the nav take it. Watch us make this crazy right-hand turn. How far are we from Fort Lauderdale? 5 miles. Fort Lauderdale traffic, Seminole 806 Alpha Mike is 5 miles to the southwest at 5,000 feet. We'll transition directly over the airport. Transitioning out, still climbing to 7,000 to the northeast, Fort Lauderdale International. It's kind of a garbled transmission. You gotta reduce the vertical speed as you gain altitude here. That's the danger, right? It can't climb out via an actual indicated airspeed. So, gotta keep reducing it as we get higher. But here we go, we're almost to 7,000, so we go 100. So we did good. We actually passed over Fort Lauderdale. On the inbound should be around 5,000 feet. Which one are they? Yeah. Or 080 is our radial from Fort Lauderdale right now. You can see we're about 5 miles to the northeast. it's time for our cruise. Power set. Okay, power. We might say, hey, we're getting into some precip. How are we good here? Well, let's take a look at our temperature. Outside air temperature. Can I get a light on it? There we go. Put my little headlight on it, little flashlight. So you can see 60 degrees up here, so we're just a tad under 60, so maybe 18 centigrade. So we're probably 55 degrees. 65% rated power, so at 2300, at 7000, we want to be at 22. Oh, we're at 23. Looking good. We are. Can't quite see. See, it does get more rusty. Yeah, we got our life raft. There's nothing below us, but. Well, we're going to want to begin our descent in 7 minutes. Okay. So, if you think about it, we're at 7,000 feet. We need to go down to 2,000. So, that's a difference of 5,000 feet. Take our, so that's 5, right? Take our obligatory times 3. That's 15 nautical miles that we need. So, call it 20. 20 nautical miles that we're going to need to arrive at Zupod at 2,000. So, somewhere 20 miles before Zupod. And so we'll be able to see that. Yeah. So we'll be able to see it right here. We'll, once we cross Patis, we'll see Zupod, and we'll see the distance. Once we get to 20 nautical miles, we'll see if the VNAV is kind of in line with that. So that's our plan, though. 20 nautical miles before Zupod, we're going to start our descent to 2,000 feet at 700 feet per minute. Let's see if that works. Let's just take a look at the airport really quick. I have some time. Okay, we're going to go into 24, 248. Oh, big runway. Would love to stop before hotel. That's my challenge. Not sure if we could do that. That's about 1,000. Say that's probably about 1,000 feet. No, excuse me, 1,000 meters, which is probably about 3,000 feet there, maybe. That's the goal. Stop before hotel. Vacate hotel left, and away we go. And we, you know, just stay in hotel all the way down. And then we'll go from there. Freeport. A lot of people call it Grand Bahama. I listen to people call it Grand Bahama all the time. It's not as Freeport, guys. It's Freeport. I mean, if you come on the frequency and say Grand Bahama traffic, this is what you're going to get from Buster. Alright, just kidding. I think I've done it many times. When I first started out, I was calling it Grand Bahama. Alright, we know what we're going to do. Vacate left on hotel. If we float the sucker, it's going to be Echo. If we pass Echo and Bravo, yeah, that's going to get a big growl from Buster. So if we get hotel, if we get Echo or Bravo or pass, that's what we're going to get. Okay, all right, Buster, I see how you are. Checks here. Ooh, nice. We're flying. Ground speed almost 200. Man, we're getting there quick. We're gonna be at Patis in 3 minutes. So that will be when we need to check our fuel. How convenient. Everything is in the green. We get more out there, Marsh Harbor, other places. Look at those shadows from the clouds. Interesting. It's raining out there. Which brings me to the next one. Wow, War Prairie just went IFR. Direct line going to Zupod, which is good. Okay, message. Guy looks up. I mean, I'm close. There we go. Approaching VNAP profile. Really? 4 minutes. See, if we did 400 feet right now per minute, we would be at Zupod at 2,000. Interesting, so 4 minutes. Let's go back. Okay, so we're 36 miles away from Zupod. We said 20 miles would begin our descent. I will say we will pick up quite a bit of speed, and so 20 may not be enough. We probably would need 25, which probably goes in line with the VNAV. Yeah, I'll pull the speed back, obviously. I'll put the car repeat on it, but we'll see. Oh, you know what I'm going to do? I want to tune in. I want to tune in the VOR, because there is a VOR here. At 113.2. 20 miles away. Perfect call. Freeport traffic, Seminole 806 Alpha Mike is 20 miles to the southwest, inbound for a left downwind 24 RNAV Freeport. Okay. Still nobody out there, but you never know. So she had people flying in observer mode. Don't want to let them down, right? I mean, maybe there's someone sitting on the airport, you know, and they're sitting there in observer mode, or maybe there's someone flying right behind in observer mode. Yeah, we gotta do it right, as much as we can. Love that scene. Today we're taking it kind of easy with that scene. Alright, so here we are. Let's go ahead. It's So probably gonna be what, a 2-4? 2-4? Look at that. 2-4 radial, 2-4-0. Oh, here we are. No. You see the airport buster? Where's that? Really? You see a buster? Probably right there. Okay. Oh, right there. Thank you, buster. Okay. Oh, here we are. Look at this. Okay. So let's get back in regular mode. There, look, 24 miles to Zupod. VNAV's almost at 700. Or VDEV, maybe. VSR, they call it. Saying descend to target. Yeah, let's go ahead and start the descent. Landing light on. Let's get our carb heat. Alright, airport traffic, Seminole 6 Alpha Mike is on a left downwind for runway 24 on the RNAV approach. Freeport. Freeport traffic. Bama. We'll hit our gear. Bama, we hit the gear. Start doing our flaps. I think we should be on, three degrees. So we gotta be inside Bama. LNAV. Lateral and vertical. Beautiful. Yep, we like that. Buster seat. We might see the runway. Oh, we're 10 miles out. I would have thought that was the runway. Traffic, Seminole 6 Alpha Mike, 8 mile final for runway 24, Freeport. Let's make sure that we have our gumps. Okay. Here is the dam. Pumps are on. It's looking good. wins were 290. It's kind of out of here. 290 at 5. We're at 1,000. Fully configured. Flaps are fully down. Gears down. Extra rich. Props high. Coming in around 95. This will be about 80, 85. Short field will be 75. Okay. Freeport traffic. Seminole 6 Alpha Mike, 5 mile final for runway 24. Freeport. Oh, how did I get off on? That is so interesting. We got it. Bam. I'm not so sure how that happened. I gotta constantly look at our comms cluster. Freeport traffic. Seminole 6 Alpha Mike, short final for runway 24. Two whites, two reds, 500 feet. I'll take over at 300. Let's see, where are we? This approach is 400. Got it. This approach altitude, and yeah, this approach rate, 2,000 feet of the street. Alright, we're good. My airplane. Number. Hotel. Pitch for speed. Freeport traffic, Seminole 6 Alpha Mike, vacated 24 off of hotel, taxiing back to ramp via hotel, Freeport. What do you think, Buster? Yeah, so I smoked the brakes a little bit. It's all good. Flaps up. Good, landing light off. Keto heat off. Fin strobe on. Fuel pumps off. Flaps confirmed. Cowl. We need to open the cowl. I want to do a one engine taxi, Buster. Yeah. So usually I've been shutting down the right engine, but let's shut the left engine down for this taxi. Ready? Shut the left engine down. There he is. Shut down. Give us some air. Okay. Push the parking brake off. It's the left engine that's completely off, so. Oil pressure's off. Everything's off. Good. So give us a little bit. Try to equalize the time here, right? On top of that, let's make sure we draw back here. Let's get our fuel selectors. Crossfeed. There. Crossfeed. Here we go. Right engine. likes a 1-engine taxi. It's a long way. I mean, Buster, we probably should have let the plane go down the runway. I mean, Buster likes a 1-engine taxi. We're only taxiing like this, Buster. I don't like taxiing out like this. Hooray! Uh-oh. Taxi like this, you gotta do everything opposite. It's like flying an RC. I think I better throttle back. I can't go pretty quick. I'm not very good at this. Do everything opposite. Screenshots, Buster. Our 1-engine taxi. One right there, man, we're right on the yellow. Look at that. Oh no. Don't get greedy. Let's see where the taxi lane is. Is it the oil mark? Oil? Yeah, oil. If I keep it on oil, I think we're good. See it? Where is it? Left of me. Where's the red dot? Red button. Our annunciator button. The annunciator button? Yeah, could be the annunciator button. Just like right under me, I don't know. Going to Mosh Haba next. Oh, we got someone else here. No. Someone just overhead. Not a bad sim. Look, our frequency changed again. We got, like, frequency gremlins. Must have a button somewhere that's really messing me up. I'll have to check that out. That can't happen. Hit the sus. Boom. Missed approach. Alright, so we gotta check out the comms. Getting a little bug in the comms. That could be, I got maybe a button preset, or I'm hitting some button and it's causing the comms to change. We'll have to check that out. Long taxi, Buster. Going this rate, We'll equalize the engines in no time. Did I kill our only engine? That's okay, Buster. Hey, Buster. Look at that. That Buster. Alright folks, that's how we do that. We are having a great blast, Buster and I. We are going to take this bad boy over to Marsh Harbor, and from there, who knows where, but we're gonna go to Marsh Harbor next. We're gonna fuel back up, and we'll take it from there. I think the fuel, yeah, you could see 525 pounds. We had 648 pounds, so 50 75, so that's about 120 some odd pounds, which is about right. And we lost how many gallons here? We started with 108 gallons, and here we have 88 gallons, so it's about 20 gallons for the trip. So 20 gallons times 6, 120 pounds, and so that's about right. That's what we have to go on. Let me make a note of that, just so we have 88 gallons on the land, 525 pounds, and so that gives us, we burned 20 gallons, and it was about 120 pounds. So we'll put 20 gallons back in, and we'll be on our way in the next episode. Hope you guys enjoyed it. We did, right, Buster? Have a good one. See you next time, guys.